one day my mother, it was summertime, my mother says, go out and get a job. So I called Chaz and I said, you got any money? And he says, I got $2 or something. I had $2. So we put some gas in my car. Instead of going looking for a job, we drove to Hollywood. And I'm going down Sunset Boulevard and there's a big building. It says, United Recording Studios. I said, let's go in and see about making a record. And he says, are you members of the union? We said, no. Well, we have to put a beep on your record every 10 seconds. So I said, I'm not interested in that. So we get back in the car, we drive down a little further, and it says Liberty Records. So we go in there, and I said, I want to make a record. And the girl at the front desk says, the studio's around the corner on La Brea. They didn't ask anything about union things. So I didn't really have any money or anything. She gave us the rates. So we're driving down La Brea, heading back towards Palos Verdes. And I stop at a phone booth, called back to the studio and booked studio time.
So we pooled our allowance. We rented some time at Liberty Recording Studio, went in.
I think it cost me $29 or $39.
Spent about an hour or two and recorded 5 tracks.
Mr. Moto had 2 takes because I kind of didn't like how I played the chorus. So I said, one more time. Other than that, it was all first takes and we were out the door.
And took home an acetate, you know, like a little on-the-spot disc that they pressed for us, and took that thing home and played it over and over again. We were just so excited, and we were sure that we were going to be on the Ed Sullivan Show here pretty quick.
And then we walked up and down Hollywood Boulevard and Sunset Boulevard knocking on doors.
We ended up signing with Arvee Records, which was named for the owner, Richard Vaughn, who I don't really remember him at all.
The record came out and it didn't do anything for like 6 months. And Sonny Bono was the promotion man. And I'd go up in my Huaraches and my T-shirt and I'd say to Sonny, how's my record doing? He'd say, it's a bomb, baby, it's a bomb. And I thought, great, my record's exploding all over the country. And then I finally found out it wasn't doing anything.
And as far as we could tell, they were kind of asleep at the switch. So we started hyping the record to the radio stations. We got our friends to call in and request it. And
at that time, KRLA was running these things where they played the top 10 from high schools every night on Sam Riddle's show.
It came on at 9 o'clock every night. It was called Topic Youth. And every night, he would highlight a different high school. And he would play the top 10 records that high school submitted. We started creating these phony surveys.
So I sent in had her make up a list of the top 10. Of course, Mr. Moto was number one.
I created a whole bogus top 10 for the Redondo High School where I was going. And there was a big splash that night. You know, that night it was all about Redondo High School, and Mr. Moto was number one on the Redondo High School survey.
And then one night he plays the top 10 from Palos Verdes High School. He says, I don't know who you guys are, but good luck, and there it goes. And I went, just nuts.
If you saw the movie That Thing You Do, you know exactly what it was like for a bunch of young kids to wake up in the morning and hear the song playing on the radio. I mean, I got a big boost every morning. I would, because they always played it right before the news. The old radio format, they would always play the instrumentals before the news because they could fade out into the news. And so right every morning at 8 o'clock as I'm getting ready to go to school, I could turn on the radio and hear Mr. Moto. Big thrill.